Welcome to an example on how to graph the standard equation of a parabola when the vertex is not at the origin and the parabola opens left or right. Notice our equation fits this form of the standard equation of a parabola, where the y part is squared and the x part is to the first power. This is the reason why the parabola opens to the left or right. For a quick review, if the x part was squared and the y part was to the first power, the parabola would have a vertical axis, meaning it would open up or open down. But again, in our case, the y part is squared and the x part is to the first power, so we have a horizontal axis of symmetry pictured here, where the parabola will open left or right based upon the sine of a. So going back to our example, the vertex will have coordinates hk, which means since we have the quantity x minus 4, the x coordinate is positive 4, and because we have the quantity y plus 3, the y coordinate is negative 3. And now we'll determine the value of a to determine whether the parabola opens to the right or opens to the left. If a is positive, it opens to the right. If a is negative, it opens to the left. Looking at the form of our equation, notice that 4a is equal to negative 4. So 4a equals negative 4. We would divide both sides by 4 to solve for a. Notice that a is equal to negative 1. And since this is negative or less than 0, the parabola will open to the left, which means it'll open around the negative x-axis. So even though the notes have a parabola that opens to the right, we can still use the key information to help us find the components of our parabola. But for the next step, we're going to make a rough sketch of a parabola with the vertex at 4, negative 3 that opens to the left, because this will give us information about the location of the focus and directrix. So the vertex would be 4, negative 3 or here. And then because the parabola opens to the left, it would look something like this. Again, we're just going to use this to help us find the focus and directrix. Make a better sketch later. So now the main thing to remember is that the distance from the vertex to the focus is equal to the absolute value of a units, and the distance from the vertex to the directrix is also equal to the absolute value of a units. So notice that we have a equals negative 1, and since the absolute value of negative 1 is positive 1, that means the focus would be 1 unit to the left of the vertex, because we know the focus would be inside the parabola, or the parabola wraps around the focus. This also means that the directrix, or this vertical line here, must be 1 unit to the right of the vertex, passing through this point here, because we know the directrix would be outside the parabola. So this should be our directrix. So just by looking at the coordinate plane, we can see the coordinates of the focus would be 3, negative 3. We could also find the coordinates of the focus by adding a to the x-coordinate of the vertex. Notice 4 plus negative 1 is positive 3. But again, I think if we can understand the geometry here, we don't have to memorize formulas. And then for the equation of the directrix, or this vertical line here, again, we can see the equation will be x equals 5, or we could subtract a from the x-coordinate of the vertex. Notice that 4 minus negative 1 would be 4 plus 1, which would give us 5. And then for the equation of the axis, or axis of symmetry, which should be this horizontal line here, notice how the parabola is symmetrical across this line. We can also think of it as a line that cuts the parabola in half, or if we fold the parabola across this line, it matches up perfectly with the other half. Notice how it also passes through the focus and the vertex. So this would be our axis, or axis of symmetry. Notice it's a horizontal line passing through y equals negative 3, which is the equation of the axis, y equals negative 3. Notice how this is also the y-coordinate of the vertex. And now for the last step, we'll find the endpoints of the focal diameter, also called the lattice rectum. The main thing to remember about the focal diameter, or lattice rectum, is that it's this segment here that's parallel to the directrix, passes through the focus, and both endpoints are on the parabola. The focus is actually the midpoint of this segment as well, and it has a length equal to the absolute value of 4a. Well, going back to our equation, notice that 4a is equal to negative 4. The absolute value of negative 4 is positive 4. So the lattice rectum or focal diameter has a length of 4 units. And since the focus is the midpoint, if this is our focus, one endpoint would be 2 units above the focus, and the other endpoint would be 2 units below the focus, or this point here. So this segment here is the lattice rectum or focal diameter. Notice how the endpoints have coordinates 3, negative 1, and 3, negative 5. Notice how we could also find these coordinates by adding and subtracting 2 from the y-coordinate of the focus. Notice negative 3 plus 2 is negative 1, and negative 3 minus 2 is negative 5. But again, if we understand the geometry, we're not memorizing formulas. And now because we know that the endpoints are going to be on the parabola, we can make a more accurate graph of our parabola. Using the vertex and the two endpoints, our parabola would look something like this. So notice how even though in our notes our parabola opened to the right, we're able to use these notes with what we know about the properties of a parabola to find all the information that we needed. Okay, I hope you found this example helpful.